Hey y'all, welcome in. I'm putting together some cardstock earrings. I did them a little different than I normally do them. These are 2.5 inch. These are 2.5 inch. And what I did this time, instead of just I printed it out on the sticker vinyl, but then instead of just cutting the sticker vinyl, I stuck the sticker vinyl to the cardstock and then cut it. That way I didn't have any trouble trying to layer it up to the cardstock perfectly. So that was something different that I tried. And now I'm just gonna put them together. So that's what we're doing. Getting a layer. Since this already stuck to a layer of the 110 pound cardstock, I'm only going to use 3 of the middle for the middle layering. And did I cut it? Let me see. I think I did cut it before I started. Did I cut? Let me see. Because I was cutting glitter for the back. I did. So I'm going to use glitter for the backs. On the other earrings I did, I used the image to do the back of the earring. But this time I'm going to do a little bit different and add glitter. Glitter backing. So I'm just applying some Mod Podge onto this cardstock layer. I want to get a good amount. I don't want too much Mod Podge. Just enough. But I want to make sure I get all the way to the edges, because that counts. Now, for the live, I'm just going to go breeze through them and build the whole earring. But usually, I would let it set some to dry before I add the image. But see, I did it different this time. So, I don't need to let it set. We're going to try this method. Welcome in. So I just get that pushed down, and I use that paper towel to catch any excess so it's not all over the place and all over my hands. So that's layer number 2. This will be layer number 3 that's going down. Next, just make sure I get all around the edges. So now line up the hole, make sure it's lined up, and push everything down. So that's pretty much done. Okay, now I already had that sticker paper stuck to this because I cut it out like that. I printed it on the sticker paper first. If you're just cutting, I printed it on the sticker paper first. Print and cut in Cricut. And then I stuck the sticker paper, sticker vinyl is what it is, sticker vinyl to the 110 pound cardstock. Then let Cricut cut it out. So I didn't have to worry about trying to stick this image to my base layer and get it off centered, or you know, not lined up. So now we're going, this is three layers glued together already, and now we're going to glue together the image layer that is already attached to one layer of the cardstock. So that's four layers per earring. Now with this sticker vinyl, I use AIVA sticker vinyl. It does not need any sealing. You can leave it as is. It's waterproof. It's almost damage proof. Because it's very durable. So now I'll just grab my image. Line it up. Touch it, stick it down, then make sure it is lined up with the hole, and then just push it down. This paper towel is damp. A little, because I was just using it to clean that brush, but it will not hurt your sticker paper. Well, this sticker paper. So if you get a little glue on there, you can wet your paper towel and wipe it off. So there is a little bit there. I can wipe that off though. So that's that. And then for the back, I didn't take these off the mat yet. I'm just going to use a gold glitter. Hey, bro. Welcome in. Get that put down. Get that on there, line it up. Stick it down. Hey, Karina, how are you? Now you could take the back, if you're going to do it glitter and you're not going to do any UV resin or resin to seal it, you can do that if you want to. It's not, you don't have to do it if you don't want to. But again, with this vinyl, I can wipe this off, this little bit of glue on here. I can wipe it off with a paper towel because it's waterproof. But with the back, if you're going to do glitter on the back, then you'll want to seal that with this, because you know that touching that glitter will rub it off, or you know, oils on your hand. You can seal that glitter with this. And a tip, if you want to seal it before cutting it, you can just take the glitter sheet outside, spray it, and then once it's dry, then you can cut it with the machine. So that's one of Jason. See, I did these on live. These are bigger. These are 3-inch. I did them pretty much the same method, except for this is photo paper. So I glued it down just like the other layers. So you can see that's 2.5 inch, that's 3 inch. But this one has the image on the back as well. So that's one, Jason. Let's put the other one together. Again, if you're just coming in, I'm building earrings out of cardstock and sticker vinyl. You could do it with photo paper as well. So this is my image and it's already attached to one layer of cardstock. Then there's another layer and another and another. So 4 layers of the black cardstock. Then you have an image layer and then your back layer, which can be another image layer if you'd like. But how I did this set is I print and cut on my sticker vinyl first. And after it printed, then I stuck the sticker vinyl to the black cardstock. This is 110-pound cardstock. I stuck it to here and then cut it out. Put it on the mat and cut it out with the Cricut. That way, I don't have to fuss with trying to line the sticker paper up with this base layer. And because sometimes it's off. Like for this one, I did it with photo paper. If you can see that little white there at the back, it's not all the way lined up with the base layers perfectly. So I changed that up. So now we can get into the build of the second earring. And we just add some Mod Podge to this first layer. You can brush it on, dab it on, however. I'll do both. But I like the dab better. Yes, I have some puff paint. Yes, ma'am, I have puff paint. Oh, let me put that over there so I don't make a mistake. So I glue this right on down. Stick it down. Yes, ma'am, I have some neon puff paint colors. They're in a box. So that's 2 layers there. I'm gonna add the 3rd layer. Get down, line the holes up. Now, if you get this too wet, you know this paper will buckle. That's why I like to, if I have some time, I like to get my layers together, let it dry, maybe put it under a book before I add my image. But if it's not flat, you could push it down or bend it a little bit before you put the image on. Oh, I've never painted. I've only sublimated tumblers. I don't do that extra stuff. I've never seen anybody put puff paint on tumblers, but I'm pretty sure you could, but I'm not sure how long it will last on the tumbler unless you sealed it in with resin or some sort of something, because that puff paint can peel right off. Hey, Deanna. Because it'll peel right off your shirt if you pull it hard enough. Or over time, put it in the dryer, I think. I used the dryer, you could peel it right off. I've never seen anybody put it on a tumbler. So that's three layers there. And we're going to add this image layer, which is attached to a layer already. So that would be your four black layers. But this one has the image already attached. Oh, she did. Yeah, because I was just thinking like, sure you can, but if you epoxy it, it'll stay on. If not, it's coming off. Okay, yeah. Tag me or send it to me. Send me the link. Thanks for the likes. Thank you. So that is the image layer. I keep getting some glue on there, but I'll wipe it off wet. I'll use a wet wipe and wipe it off. That's what I like about this sticker vinyl. I can wet it. But not too much because that paper, there's still paper back there. So that's there. And now it's for the back. I'm going to do that glitter layer. These are 2.5 inch. This is the size I start in, like for custom orders and stuff. That I start in 2.5. I don't have anybody wanting any smaller ones, but I probably would do smaller, like 1.5, something like that. But this is cool if you want to build yourself. You can also, you don't have to use cardstock. You can do this with the acrylic blanks as well that people use to make keychains, the round or whatever shape. You can do whatever shape you want to do, but you can use those blanks as well. So it's just a glitter layer. And I'm lining it up. And then I'm gonna push it down. So again, with the glitter layer, you will want to use this lacquer, Rust-Oleum. You can find it in the spray paint section at Walmart. And if you want to spray the whole sheet of glitter before cutting it, you can do that. That might be easier than trying to spray cut circles, you know. So spray your sheet, let it dry. If you want to give it more than one coat, spray one coat, let it dry. It's good now if you do it now too, because it's so hot, if it's hot where you're at, like it is where I am. So that's that. So we got, and then I would add the jump rings, which I'm just going to go into the next build. I'm not going to do that right now. So that's Jason. The back is glitter. Boom, boom. And if you saw me make these on live, this is the size difference. This is 3 inch. This is 2 inch. Thanks for the lies. Hey, bae. I saw you down there for a second. Hey. So that's Jason. And next up, we got some GG. So I got three layers of 110 pound cardstock. If you can get thicker, you're more than welcome to get thicker. Watercolor pads at Walmart. You can get the Grumbacher pad. It is, if you want to use white for your layers, you can. And if you get the watercolor pad, you could probably do this in two layers because it's thick. It's thicker. This is Grumbacher, and it's the 9x12 watercolor pad. And this paper is 140 pounds. I like the black better myself, so that's why I use it more. I just think that it looks better. You can use them neon colors as well. I think some of those are like the Astro Brights is 65 pound, but you will have to use more layers. Hi Trisha Creations, I created it. So again, we got the three. We're gonna need three layers of 110-pound cardstock, and then our image is on a layer already, so that will create the fourth layer. But as I said before, I had used sticker paper and stuck it to the cardstock before I cut the cardstock before I cut it out. Thanks, Trisha. So, layer one. Let's get some Mod Podge down. Get our Mod Podge down. Then put on layer two. Line up our holes. And then push it down to set it. Thanks for the likes. I appreciate it. So that's it. We're gonna move on to the third layer. Glue and some more glue, and apply the third layer. Up and push it down. Like so. No. I won't be selling those images. I do sell images. My website is ArkishaGraphics.com, ArkishaGraphics.com. You can access it from the link tree in my bio. And I also, you can access my Etsy shop. I have some images in there, but these are not there. So that was the third layer, guys. And let me say this. If you were going to use an image for the front and then the same image for the back, then you know that's already two layers. You would only need two of these to go with this if you attach it like I did, because it's already attached. So this is the fourth layer and it already has the image on it. Yes, Trisha, check me out. I have images. I do have images. Now, I might do the earring images. I may. Uh-oh, I was about to stick that in the water. I may do the earring images. I'm not sure yet. Because I have images just like the image that's exactly like this for tumblers as well. So, I just took the tumbler and made it into an earring image. So, I might do them. Because I sell earring design templates. So all you have to do is buy the template, print, then cut, and put it together. So I do sell those. They're on my website as well. And that's ArkishaGraphics.com. ArkishaGraphics.com. And the earring templates will be listed under jewelry. Jewelry templates, I think. And maybe, yeah, I think it's jewelry templates. Let's get this pushed down, lined up. Okay. Picasso. So now let's add the back. So for the back, we're going to do the same thing. And we're going to add a gold back. Mod Podge down. We're going to get this glitter layer lined up. The holes lined up. And then we're going to push it down as well. I'm going to put my fingers on it. Okay, get it pushed down. Thank you. I might do the earrings on my website. I'm not sure yet. I just got them all created, so I haven't really went to the website to do any website work, so I'll be there soon. Okay. Picasso. That looks really good. Get in a little glue on it with this sticker vinyl. I can just wet a paper towel and wipe it off really, really good. And I won't have to do any sealing to this. This sticker vinyl is pretty good. And like I said, for this, I would seal that with this. I did not do that, but these are not for these earrings. I'm not selling. I'm just doing this for the live. But if I sell some for an order, I would seal it. The back with the Rust-Oleum lacquer. The front needs no sealing. And then care for these. You just don't get them wet. Just don't get them wet. Don't scratch real hard. I mean, you know, don't try to damage it. But alcohol does not affect these. Water does not affect these. They'll be fine. But I would seal that glitter with that Rust-Oleum because touching it with your oils, the oils in your hand and just rubbing it rubs glitter off. So that one is cute. And again, I made these online, but this is photo paper, but it's the same layer method. So these are 3 inch. So you can get an idea. These are 2 inch. So you can make them any size you would like. Any size. This printed really pretty. There's that one. So I cut 2 more of these because I was going to do, I first was going to do the image on the front and the back. But then I changed my mind. I'm going to make 2 pair. Probably make a pair for my sister. So now the second earring. To the next. I'm gonna stick my brush in that water. I need to clean it. I edge. Make sure you get all to the edges of the paper. So you can get a good stick down. Hey, OG. How are you? So this is layer one. This is layer two. This paper towel over here for now. Use our thanks, babe. Okay, love you. So that's two layers there. Go ahead and add the third one. Third layer. Line it up. Push it down. Easy peasy, guys. Not hard at all. You can customize any outfit. Let's say you go get a cute little skirt for church or wherever you're gonna go, an event, and it has a nice pattern on it that you like. You're gonna take and hold your camera over a spot that you like on the fabric, snap a photo of it, and then upload that photo and slice it out of your template shape. Boom, you have your image. I'm making earrings, OG. So that was the third layer. Now we're gonna attach the image layer that is already attached to the fourth layer. So we're gonna attach the image layer. So that will make our four layers. But yeah, you can customize any outfit, match any outfit. Also plenty of these for memorials too. A lot of people like to get their loved ones on the earrings. I did them for graduations as well. Memorials, graduations. If you like to check out some of my stuff, guys, you can. My Instagram is Indian Zulu. The link is in the link tree in my bio, which is also my Etsy shop, Indian Zulu. But I have tons of earrings on my Instagram. Things that I've made. Hey, Viv, I didn't see you come in. Check me out on Facebook, Indian Zulu, as well. So that's the image layer. So it's done. Now we just need to add the back layer, which again is going to be glitter, gold glitter cardstock. Oh, okay. So add our Mod Podge. Make sure we get the edges good so that image can lay down all the way to at the edge, doesn't do any popping up. Try not to get that Mod Podge on the glitter because it makes it dull. Right, Picasso. Turned out really good. So guys, if you have Tumblr images, PNGs, SVGs, whatever, you can make earrings. If you make t-shirts and you use those images for your t-shirts, make some earrings. Upcharge the a little package, you know, put a little package deal together. Make a Tumblr, a shirt, some earrings, all that together. Y'all know Christmas is coming up. People is gonna be looking for unique things. People, they like unique stuff. So if you can match their tumbler, their earrings, and their shirt. So it's just gold glitter on the back. This come out super good, super, super good. So I have another pair just like that. I'm gonna probably do those on another live, save those for another live, but yep. So we did, you're welcome. So we did Jason, which he has gold on the back. These are mine, and I just did gold because I was already cutting gold, but I would have used silver because I'm a silver person, but I'll wear gold too. So we have Jason here, and then we have the Gigi purse earrings, which I make the tumbler for this as well. Well, I made the tumbler. This is the tumbler, but I've changed the file since making the tumbler first. So I made this file, this tumbler first, but as you can see, I've darkened the colors. I've done a little changing up to the file. This is still cute though. But yeah, I use Ava sticker vinyl. Let me show you guys. I use this vinyl. Take your screenshot. It is a pricey vinyl. It is on Amazon. It is a pricey sticker vinyl. So that's the Ava sticker vinyl, and it's white and it's glossy and it's for inkjet. Yes, I love it. Love it, love it, love it, love it. It holds up so well. It's waterproof. It's just a good vinyl. I use that, and I use the Recollections brand from Michaels, the 110-pound cardstock. And it's pricey too. I think it's now it's $16.99 for 100. I use that. And then I use this Mod Podge. And if I do glitter, I'm going to use this to spray the glitter. Again, if you want to spray the whole 12 by 12 glitter sheet before cutting it on the Cricut, you can do that. That will not be a problem. You can do that. I have done that before. And after I did my print and cut on the Ava vinyl, sticker vinyl, then I printed it for my Epson 8550. And then after I did that, I cut the excess white off and just stuck it to a sheet of the black cardstock. Stuck it to a sheet of that, loaded up on the printer, and let it cut. And I did that so I didn't have to fuss with not getting the image stuck down to it properly, or, you know, so it wouldn't be offset like this one. If you can see the white on that, you see that white, it should not be showing. It should be flush. And that's what it is. And I love it, love it, love it.